Oh, crunchy, yeah. Crunchy. Oh, crunch,
right. Leaking a little.
Right.
It's not going in good territory over there.
Okay.
So I've been asked if I could share how I do the tracing on my golf video. And the short intro you just been through is a demo of the After Effects project I will drive you through. So quick warning, this is not a full tutorial, so I'm expecting you to have a good knowledge of After Effects. So let's look at the different layers. You have the controller. This is a null object which summarizes the most useful setting of all the different layers in one single location. We will go in detail a little bit later. We have the layer for the ball pass, the ball shadow, the swing pass, the shot distance, and the main video, which is cut from the backswing to the end of the trace. For this project, you will also need two free plugins, the six stroke from Plugging Everything for the ball pass and the ball shadow, and the Saber plugin from Video Copilot. We will use it for the swing pass because it provides much more choice of effect than six stroke plugin. Both links will be in the description today, together with the project. So as far as the timeline is concerned, you can see here several time rulers. One is for the impact, one for the apex, one for the landing, and the last one located 1 second after the landing, where the trace and distance will start to disappear. So let me drive you through the main layers, starting with the controller. So in the controller, you have the control over the color of the trace, as well as the distance, the opacity of the trace and distance, the width of the trace, as well as the shadow. You could go higher than 2, but then you will need some manual adjustment. And finally, the cap of the trace as well as the shadow. You have a choice between either round or butt. So now starting with the ball pass. So the first thing to do is to prepare a mask to follow the ball pass. So you need to try to be as close as possible to the real ball flight. And anytime the ball is visible, it's a perfect indicator to add a node on your mask. The number of nodes is irrelevant anyway to the accuracy of the trace. You just need to be as precise as possible. So you can use 10, 20, 30, 50 nodes. It doesn't matter. Most important is to be as close as possible to the real ball flight. As far as the landing point is concerned, as usually we do not see where the ball is landing, you're going to have to estimate where the ball was landing. Once the mask is completed, we will use a six stroke to draw the ball flight. I use it because it provides a full control over the color and the thickness of the line using the vertex phaser mode. So to adjust the thickness, you just click on the six stroke, then click on the mask. And I found that the three control points located at impact just before apex and landing were sufficient to provide a smooth drawing. So the thickness of the line basically will gradually decrease between each control point, and this decrease will give a sense of perspective. The use of the multiplier to increase or decrease the overall line thickness will be directly controlled inside the controller section. For the color, we basically use one primary color that you can again choose in the controller control section. Then the three gradients that will be used to draw the line will be calculated automatically from the primary color. And If you want to change the luminosity gradient, you can just enter a new value in the expression that you can see here on the screen. The trim pass start and end value are then used to time the drawing to the ball flight. So the layer starts at the impact. At that time, the start value is 0%, and I will gradually increase the end value to follow the ball location. So moving forward frame by frame until the ball is not visible will help you to create as many frames as necessary to get a smooth follow of the drawing and the ball. You will need to estimate the timing of the ball landing, because most of the time we don't see the ball, and usually about 7 seconds is a good ballpark figures. And at that point, 7 seconds after impact, you should have the end value at 100%, and here it's located about 8 seconds on the timeline, because the impact was about 1 second after the start of the video. Then to clear the trace, I start to gradually increase this time the start value from 0% at 1 second after the landing, so 9 seconds, to 100% by the end of the video. Now, regarding the ball shadow, it's about the same principle. We create a mask, again from impact to impact zone to a landing area, following the overall shape of the ball flight. So you can have a little bit of a draw, a straight line or a fade. And that's it. The width and the style of the shadow are linked to the controller, so that both the trace and the shadow are following the same size and the same style. The color, you have manual choice here, but blacks is usually the color of choice. And you don't need to trim the ball flight, the line to the ball flight, because the trim is automatically linked to the ball trace. So the shadow will follow basically the ball trace. It will start to appear together with the ball trace, and it will disappear as well together with the ball trace. Now, regarding the distance, it's quite simple. First, there is a mask. I use a mask for the line located below the text. Then the slider is used to provide the distance. And I time the distance at the apex to be a bit more than 50% of the total distance, because the ball is traveling way faster till apex, and then gradually there is no more acceleration, and beside the gravity and the distance is a little bit less. Well, this you can adjust. I use the scale, of course, to decrease the size, and the color is a link to the color of choice in the controller. So finally, about the swing pass. So here I use a pre-composition because I wanted the head of the golfer to be visible in front of the swing pass. That's a bit complicated. You need to use a roto brush, to create a mask. So I will not provide explanation on roto brush. So let me duplicate the effect, and I will drive you through. Okay, so the principle is similar to the six stroke. You start by creating a mask to follow the club head. Okay, let me turn off the effect by reducing the core size. So here again, so you need to create the pass and to be as precise as possible. You can add as many points as you want. The most important is to have a trace, a pass that is as close as possible to the shape of the swing. Once completed, just use saber to apply the effect of your choice. So here I use fusion. Okay, let me increase the core size back to default. You can choose among several effects, and depending on your preference, you might want to toggle between add, lighten, or screen mode. And that's it. So the link to the plugin, as well as the project link, are available in the description. And if you like the project, just leave a comment.
Oh, crunchy, crunch lemon.
Leaking a little, right?
Oh, it's not going in good territory over there.
Okay.